Hello, my name's Tim Lawrence from the Barton Hill Wall Garden Project, and we've just won the Green Volunteers Project of the Year award, which is very nice surprise. And it's been a hard year, so it's a lot of work. It's nice to get recognised for that. And we have been going about a year. We started off with an ornamental wall garden, the old vicarage on the housing estate in Barton Hill, and in the last year we've done quite a bit to physically transform that, putting in some polytunnels and a kitchen garden and the start of a forest garden. We've also built a timber frame outdoor kitchen so we can cook the food that we grow, and currently there's also a volunteer timber frame build to make a roundhouse. There's a place where people can come and be still and enjoy the beauty of the garden. It's not all about digging and working. So the wall garden is, as I said, on a housing estate, lots of concrete, lots of tarmac on the outside, but when you step through the little white door, you enter into another world, which is quite vibrant and green oasis, really, with fruit trees and vegetables and some mature old trees with swings under and a wild area for the kids to play in. And again, we've got the kitchen going. So it's like a portal to another way of being in a most unsurprising place, right under the shadow of a tower block. And we are working to try and get women and young families in there because it's a very safe space, unlike many outdoor spaces in town. And also to work with the Somali community, which make up about 40%, and they're trying to work out how do we make home in Barton Hill. So we've had a little bit of making relationships with them. In 2012, we want to build that relationship and trying to really make community with them and get the numerous volunteers to come along to really be able to own and take forward the place in their own kind of way.
Hi, I'm Rob Acton-Campbell. This is my wife, Susan. We've won the Councillor's Special Green Volunteers Award this evening, which we're very pleased to receive. We've received it for our work on Troopers Hill, which is a wonderful hill in St. George in East Bristol, covered in heather, acid grassland. It's an island of heathland, unique to Bristol, something you won't see anywhere else in the city. We're really lucky to have a view of it from our bedroom window, and we've been working with Friends of Troopers Hill since 2003, trying to getting residents involved, running work parties, holding events to try and show the residents what an important place it is. And we feel we've really made a difference over the last 8 or 9 years. We've got residents involved, and the place really looks better looked after now than it did when we started. We've done quite a lot of raising money through grants, and Susan will tell you about some of the successes we've had there.
When we started in 2003, the very first grant we applied for was just £3,000 for tools and materials to be able to do works on Troopers Hill. So litter picking, cutting back encroaching bramble and small saplings. We were successful with that grant. We were just so pleased. And then carried on going for different grants to achieve different things. And one of the best was a landfill charity grant that allowed us to replace a rotting wooden fence that was keeping motorbikes out of the hill. And now we have a lovely hedge with some discreet metal fencing, serves the purpose and actually adds to Troopers Hill and looks beautiful. And now this year we've heard about a grant for £30,000. It's taken us a year of preparation and application to get it, and lots of consultation, and thank you to everybody who replied on their questionnaires. And now we know we're looking forward to next year with improved paths, improved steps, and a wonderful woodland trail marked with discreet sympathetic markers for local people to enjoy the woodland paths. And we're going to very much enjoy the celebration event that we have to put on to meet those grant conditions.
So you can find out more on our website at www.troopers-hill.org.uk. So please visit our site and then come and visit our hill. Thank you.
My name's Nikki Bacon, and I've been working at Wimmer Hill City Farm for the last 12 years. I coordinate the volunteers and some other health and social care activities at the farm with older people and people with mental health and learning difficulties. We've got a fantastic team of volunteers from a whole range of different ages and different people with different interests. So I'm really pleased to have won this award for diversity, because I think that's the thing that we do really well at the farm. We support people who maybe wouldn't normally think of volunteering or even of working outside and getting physically active. We've got a lot of people with mental health difficulties, learning difficulties, and we've recently started working with a lot of people in drug and alcohol recovery, who not only are sort of helping with the farming and gardening, but they're also supporting other volunteers with support needs. So this afternoon I've just come from working with a team of people with learning difficulties, shoveling lots of manure, with a volunteer helping me who's in recovery, and he was telling me about how important it's been for him to be active, to feel valued and a part of the community, but also to learn about helping other people. And he's thinking of working in health and social care, but he's also enjoying being outside and the whole green gym exercise. So I really do appreciate this. I think it's going to help us to raise our profile. And also, I think it's going to be fantastic for our volunteers to see that their work is appreciated, not just by us at the farm, but by the rest of the community. And so I'm delighted to have got this award today.